Hey, mister.
Good morning.
Hey, partner.
Good morning.
Hey there.
Bonjour.
Hey there, mister.
Good morning,
mister. What do you think you are doing?
Hello. Morning to you.
Belle journée, n'est-ce pas?
You sure run into some nice folks out this way. Hi there, mister.
Fine day to you.
Madam!
Bonjour, monsieur.
Bye!
Buddy!
Hey, partner!
Hello, ladies. How y'all doing?
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning, yeah.
Thanks, Drake.
Hey there, mister. Hi there.
Mister,
you can cut that out right now.
Are you well?
Good morning, mister.
Arthur! Arthur! Up here! You came!
Yeah, I came. So, what do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down. Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, But surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... Well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you and Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else. But
I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Come along, Dan. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur, you know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
No, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But, well, I don't know.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure. He keeps saying it's a disgrace a man of his standing has to ride around on some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur. He wasn't always this way, but It has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever, pawning things off left and right, mixing with bad people. I'm just scared for him.
Well, don't worry too much. Whatever it is, we'll work it out.
Fine morning.
Howdy.
This is the place. Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you and make my apologies to the lady at your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
I've never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy, tired and
I have no such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur. He's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
This way. He went around the corner. Oh. Hold on.
You can see why he has such a high opinion of himself. We'll just follow the smell.
Arthur. Come on. He just went between those crates. Don't lose sight of him. Come here, quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go.
Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you!
He's heading across the road.
You know, this is kind of fun.
Shh, he'll hear you. He just went left down that alleyway. What's he doing?
Let's go find out. Don't say I never show you a good time.
I'm just glad you're here.
What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money. That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was Mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
No, it's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
You'll probably kill someone. Oh, would you like that, don't you, Mary?
Hey, you, Ashton, hold her right there. God damn it. Hey! Stop that, coach! You hearing me? Stop that! Damn coach!
Leave me alone. Leave me alone. It's just a brooch.
I want that brooch. It wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
How much do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
$100? What do you take me for?
Okay, okay. I'm a reasonable man. Let's say 50.
Not good enough, Ashton.
Okay, Jesus! $25, that's my final offer. Take the damn thing. You crazy son of a bitch. You don't know who you're messing with. Somebody's gonna pay for this.
Where's your father?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Well, let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.
Hey. What are you doing now? Right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Theater? Me? Sure, why not?
It'll be fun, Arthur. Let's go to the Relure. They have the strangest acts.
Strangest I can handle. Well, it's the normal business of life. I can't seem to get a grip on it.
You and me both, Arthur. Oh, I've missed you.
Don't start.
You're an idiot. But you'll always be my friend.
Well, of course I'm your friend, but... You ain't always fair with me.
If I was fair with you and a good person, I'd have had you hanged a long time ago.
Well, that's true.
So, shut up and act like a gentleman, or at least try to for once in your brainless life.
You're not a very nice woman, Mrs. Lynn.
Well, look at the company I keep.
I know, it's quite dreadful, isn't it?
It's sort of beautiful. In a gaudy and tasteless way.
It's the only way I know.
Thank you.
Oh, no, I didn't mean it like that.
I'm sure. You silly man. Come on, let's go find our seats.
How about here on the right?
Sure.
After you.
Thunderous applause. I am Aldridge T. Abington, the greatest assembler of entertainment since Nero himself. Do not doubt. As a child, when I walked the horse manure-covered streets of Saint-Denis, I never dreamed of the stir I would create in this locality
just
as
starting
a proprietor
Are you in
of
a
the
rush,
greatest
Arthur?
Show ever assembled. Prepare! For the grandest excitement of your curiosity. Fire, snakes, and magic. I encourage any of you to dabble in all three if you have a settled aversion to manual labor as I do. For entertainment is a gift that will see you through the winter better than any packed larder or root cellar full of canned goods.
Give us some more.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a truly stunning musical performance to the stage, Miss Robin Koninsky!
Say, come with me in the parlor I'd rather live in Saint Denis. Yes, I'd rather live in Saint Denis. So draw your money, come see your honey in old Saint Denis.
That girl can sing.
Flawless. Perfect. Oh, I see you. You love her dulcet tones, right? Yes, she is pure spectacle, and I assure you she can charm any beast. Any beast
that's
at all, from cockroach to killer whale. Your mother most likely told you not to play with fire.
Or
to spend time in the company of strange women. You are about to do both. Miss Antoinette Sanserino.
Right. Yeah.
Wonderful.
This lady is exotic as all get out.
Oh, wow. Yeah, do it.
I can see how this could go horribly wrong.
I hope she stays away from the curtain.
I like hot things too! This is something!
I can't think of anything worse.
She sure is hot! Y'all see this? On with the show!
Enchanting! Mesmerizing!
Pissed
she
off.
Is truly one to bring home to mother. It is said that there is a place in France where the naked
Phony.
Ladies dance. I have been there. Prepare for the body brassieres of the Petit Flaneur in Gay Paris!
Get out of here! Incredible! Aren't they lovely? Oh, those legs are a sight to behold. Trash!
I am spent. Each of my shows is truly incredulous. Awe-inspiring, and I'm sure you enjoyed. Thank you. We flounder through the morass of humanity with only bright moments like these before it all goes dim and snuffs out in silence. So thank you. What a lovely evening.
Come
back tomorrow.
All right. Well, shall we?
Yes. That was fun, Arthur.
It was.
All right. You better take me to the trolley now, Mr. Morgan.
Of course.
Quite ridiculous, but somehow very amusing.
Sure.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
I can't lie to you. Wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted too, and I can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end.
This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything, I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. Soon, I'll have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will, once I get some money. I had some. But then some fool got it trapped into a town that I can't go back to. That's another story.
I'll write you.
Yeah.
Hey there, mister.